by Robert Mugabe. It shows the squalid conditions that people are now living in. It's estimated that about 2,000 people have been dumped at Hopley Farm after their homes were demolished in a government policy of clearing urban slums. The government of Zimbabwe says that it's now stopped the demolition of homes, which could have left as many as 700,000 people homeless. Sarah Green from Amnesty told us what they'd found.
People literally there with what they could pick up and carry and take with them. So there are no facilities for people, and we're talking about large communities, so where you've got children, you've got elderly people, people who also haven't got jobs anymore, so no access to an income, so living in very, very desperate circumstances. What it also tells us is that because we had to get this footage secretly to help to show the world what is actually happening in Zimbabwe, the plight of these people is being kept secret. Robert Mugabe's response to the consequences of his demolition program has been not to help the people who he decided to move out of their homes, but actually to keep the consequences secret, so they need to be revealed in this manner. All we can estimate is that there may be tens of thousands, even hundreds of thousands of people living in Zimbabwe like this. Amnesty doesn't have the resources to measure and to monitor all of that, but the Zimbabwean government won't make it public. So what we want them to do when we look at these images today is to first of all tell us how many people are living like this, who are they and where are they, and then secondly grant access to humanitarian agencies who can provide some help with food and housing, because that's the other major issue here. The Zimbabwean government is still not granting access to international aid agencies, nor to the UN's World Food Programme, and it does actually desperately need help. We do have corroborating reports that this kind of desperate situation is faced by other people in other parts of the country, so we think it's very concerning because we see no evidence at all of real plans put in place to help people. You can't go in with force and evict people and demolish and ruin their homes. You can't do that without a plan and clear resources for where to take them and what to do next, beyond the issues of consent and those people allowing that to happen to them and to their lives and livelihoods. This is yet a further indication of Robert Mugabe's government's complete disregard for the basic human rights of all of the population of Zimbabwe. And it's time that, that we really must see some concerted pressure on him.
Sarah Green of Amnesty International.